says...
The cosmic microwave background is a form of electromagnetic radiation that fills the entire universe.
Student B says...
Who is right?
There I sat, working diligently on my astronomy project.
Dude.
Hey man, let me play.
Dude, let me just beat this castle.
Hey, isn't your project due tomorrow?
Jerk.
Truth was, I hadn't even lifted a finger to doing my project. I hadn't even thought twice about my topic.
You don't happen to know anything about the cosmic microwave background, do you? Yeah, that's what I thought. This is bad.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm a victim of some wicked ADD. And the cosmic microwave background was the last thing I wanted to think about.
It's time for a study break.
What are you gonna do, dude?
Probably go down the river, throw rocks in it. You wanna come?
Nah, man, I'd rather sit here and watch the night car.
Alright.
Peace!
Abandoned train tracks behind my house served as a nice location to get some fresh air. My mind wandered around freely for a while, just sitting there zoning out. But for some reason, an intense desire to understand the cosmic microwave background began to come creeping up into my brain.
I have procrastinated long enough. What's up, Bish? How you do? I'm good, bro. Hey, I need you to do me a favor.
You want to get down to that last wish, don't you?
That's right, you damn genie.
Before I go on any further, I have to let you know about my friend Abdul. We met at a party one night when I was really drunk. I needed a ride home and he said he could give me a lift. On the way home, the munchies took over, so I asked my new friend Abdul for a Whataburger, and one just appeared out of thin air right before my eyes. Turns out Abdul was a freaking genie. Unfortunately, I had already used two wishes. A ride home and a damn cheeseburger. I asked if I could think really hard about my last wish and save it for another day. Abdul gave me his number and told me to call him up whenever I figured it out. I was gonna blow it on something silly like $1 million. But for some strange reason, I had to figure out about the cosmic microwave background. And this is bugging me.
Hold your nuts, I'll be right over.
What you need?
I wish to understand the cosmic microwave background.
That's a damn weird wish.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Just go look on Wikipedia.com, man.
I actually want to understand it, like, really get it.
Okay, your wish is my command.
take that.
Then what?
You will go on an unconscious journey that will take but an instant. In your mind, however, you will become the cosmic microwave background. You will live its birth, its life, and finally, its death. You will consciously feel like you are the light that was first emitted from the Big Bang. Only then will you understand what it is.
Cool.
But beware!
Dude.
Seeing what you are about to see will change your human life forever.
Like in a good way, or?
Your simple human mind might not be able to handle what you are about to witness.
Am I gonna like go bonkers and become a brain dead vegetable?
Oh, that is a possibility.
Great. I think I can feel it in my legs.
Oh, the pill is just to dull the pain.
Of what?
Going unconscious.
Upon going unconscious, my mind left my body. I was no longer the human being that I had always known. I became something entirely different. I was not quite sure what I was at that moment, but the first thing I remember was seeing a single point and nothing but darkness. What I suddenly realized was that this point was the entire universe moments before the Big Bang. I knew what was coming next, so I braced myself for the explosion that would send space, time, and everything into motion. From a single point the size of a grain of sand, the universe expanded. Time seemed to pass instantaneously before my eyes. During the first 400,000 years after the Big Bang, the universe was so hot that all matter existed as plasma. During this time, photons could not travel undisturbed through the plasma. As a result, the universe was opaque, meaning light could not pass through the plasma. As the universe expanded and cooled, electrons began to bind to nuclei, forming atoms. The introduction of neutral matter allowed light to pass freely through a process known as decoupling. The light first radiated from this process is what we now see as the cosmic microwave background. I became this light as it filled the entire universe. I witnessed everything that happened in the universe all at once. I was everywhere at the same time. I saw all the billions of galaxies form. I saw all the stars being born, living, and finally dying. I saw all the planets forming. I even witnessed the formation of one tiny blue planet called Earth. My perpetual radiation rained down onto this tiny planet and into the horn-shaped antenna that was staring right back at me. The year was 1964, and two scientists named Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson were studying the Milky Way's emission at microwave wavelengths. They were doing this in order to identify and eliminate interference in planned satellite communication. But what they accidentally did was come across me, the light emitted from the Big Bang. To them, I was just a background piss that never seemed to fade and go away. They had no clue what this interference was. They tried pointing their antenna in every direction. They checked their equipment and even waited for different times of the day to work. But I remained the way I had for nearly 14 billion years, and I just kept raining down into their device. After consulting other scientists, they concluded that the origin of the mysterious static was nothing less than the fiery creation of the universe itself. They named me the cosmic microwave background. I am the oldest thing that has ever been observed by human beings. When you observe me, you are looking almost all the way to the very beginning of the universe. The photons that make up the cosmic microwave background have not interacted with matter since the universe was a mere 440,000 years old. But now those photons rain down onto everything that exists. If you wish to see me, all you have to do is turn on a TV. Some of the static that is being received in the television snow is actually the radiation from the cosmic microwave background. Your journey is now over.